SOAP, or the Simple Object Access Protocol, has been a popular messaging protocol in the early 2000s. It uses XML as a format with a well-defined schema and your choice of transport protocol. So that could be HTTP or TCP or whatever, right? SMTP. Despite it still being used, people have been moving towards REST architecture instead and recently toward gRPC and other protocols as well. In this episode, we discuss why people moved from SOAP, what was wrong with it, and what are the advantages and disadvantages of SOAP coming up. What's up, y'all? This is Hussein Nasser from iGeometry, where we discuss software engineering by example, and let's just get into it. Yeah, today we will discuss SOAP and what is exactly why people have been moving towards SOAP. So, but before we do that, let's go back way back in the 90s and even before. You know, people have been writing apps, right? There wasn't anything with the concept of networking, right? People are writing apps, and their apps or their software were sitting in the same box, right? So you would call a method or you called a function call, and this is exactly in the same machine, right? So then they wanted, hey, you want networking. So that thus became the RPC, right? The remote procedure or call, right? The protocol to call a method on the network. So people have been inventing their own thing, just randomly making up protocols. You know, there were non-standard, so SOAP came and said, hey guys, we need to put some standard. People have been writing their own apps, and for this networking we need a standard. So W3C came and says, you know what, this is a standard, guys, let's use XML. It's extensible, right? Because you can put your own tags. It's really cool. And we're going to make it flexible enough so you can write your own message in this schema. You have to use this schema, right? So you don't have to make up, you don't have to just send up a weak or not strongly typed messages across the network, right? So if the server receives thing, it knows the schema. It always know how to interpret a message. So they started to put all these restriction kind of in place, and this is what happened, right? We had the SOAP. So by using XML, that means it's pretty cool. So it's a human readable, people can read it. Back then it was important for some reason, right, to read the messages across the network. Not anymore. And just that choice of making XML actually hurt, right? And we're gonna talk about it today as well, right? And the flexibility is, hey, you can use it on HTTP, TCP, SMTP. Just write your own this simple SOAP server and write your own SOAP client, and you're done. Then you write your own client that consumes the SOAP client, and then the server that receives the SOAP server messages and start doing all this stuff. That so you can do the work, right? But then started, there were a lot of problems as a result of this. Like, so we were thinking a lot about the schema and how to make this as rigid and regimented as possible, right? And this is the result. So what is wrong with that? So let's move to the advantages and disadvantages for this. Advantages: what did we get of the schema, right, of the SOAP schema? That's a very good thing, right? Because if I receive a message, if someone sent me a bogus message, I just discard it, right? And that's cool, because now hackers can't just send me stuff. They have to send me that. If a client, if I know the client, they have to send me the exact same message in this exact format, and these tags has to be in place, right? And if there is a specific version, I know, right? All this stuff, right? So there's a schema. That's an advantage, which will be a disadvantage in a minute. Extensible, because XML, right? Unlike HTML, which is like a very specific tags, XML, you can just invent your own tags. And as long as you write your SOAP server to parse or know these tags, then you're good, right? So it's still the same protocol, still the same language, but you have extensibility. Your application can extend those messages. It's not, you're not just defined by these set of headers, right? You can invent and add stuff as well. Flexible transport, so that's another disadvantage, I mean, right? So we have it, you can put the SOAP on HTTP or SMTP, for example, simple mail transfer protocol, I think, yeah. And TCP, you can write your own protocol. Just the transfer doesn't matter as long as the message exactly looks this way. All right, let's get to it. Why it's bad? Why people have been moving it? What's the disadvantage of this, right? Let's get to it. The cons or the disadvantage of this is actually the way the schema is implemented, right? So if you think about it here, the client makes a request to the SOAP client, which is a thick client that sits on top of your application, and then it transfers everything and deserialize or serialize everything into XML, sends it across HTTP or SMTP, and then the SOAP server will deserialize and then pass the message to the server. So that's the current architecture. So having a schema, a very rigid schema, is actually a problem, because now people who just want to write an app, they have to adhere to a schema which slows down adoption. Says, you know what, I don't want to just write a schema now. I just want to send it like a JSON format or something like that, right? I just want to send something and I want to receive it. And this could change. My message could have these properties, and next time I could lose a property or I could add a property. I don't want to be tied to a schema. So people did not like, some people didn't like that. Although a schema, some people prefer a schema, some people do. That's why we have SQL and NoSQL, right? The schema is still a debatable concept here. So having strictly a schema kind of slows down adoption, and people move to a more open architecture, which is the REST, right? Which you can have your own schema. It doesn't really care. It doesn't really have to have a schema per se. XML, the choice of XML. That means, first, it's a very large bandwidth sucking protocol or language, right? Because now all these tags are just consuming bandwidth on the network, and it's very slow to process, right? You have to process these strings. These are nothing but strings. Remember, tags are nothing but strings. They're huge strings to send something that is so simple. I have to wrap it up with all this fancy tags, right? Which slows down parsing. So that's another, yeah, people being turned off by that, right? Thick clients. Why do I need to write, and instead of my client, I have to write something else to do the serialization? And that made the SOAP protocol not language agnostic, because okay, if I'm using VB.NET, right, then I have to write an my SOAP client has to be obviously living in my client, so it has to be written in VB.NET. And if I'm using, I don't know, JavaScript or any other language, or PHP or C# or C++, there must be a SOAP version of whatever I'm using to add it, a thick client that get added to my, that with the service mesh, this now becomes much, much better. I'm gonna make a video about service mesh. I love this technology. Whoever invented this is a genius, right? Sidecar container and all that stuff, we're gonna talk about it. But yeah, but having me to be forced to use a language just because the SOAP client is written in this language, it's pretty turn off again. Right, so yeah, because these clients do the serialization and deserialization, all that stuff. And last one is, scaling is very hard, right? If I add, let's think about not just one server. Let's just think about multiple servers. Or if my client is version 1, okay, and then I decided to make it version 2 by enhancing my message to add new fields, right? Guess what, right? Now by adding that, I just broke my compatibility. I can't just communicate with the server. Server will have to upgrade to version 2 as well, right? Because otherwise, if you send it an old message, Then SOAP says, what is that? I don't know how to present. Hey, this is a new stuff. This is not the schema I am supposed to read. Pff, fail, right? So it doesn't scale easily, right? So scaling the server by upgrading the client or upgrading the server, they cannot scale independently, right? They have to scale together, or if you upgrade this, you have to upgrade the whole thing. And I made a good video about this, and I'm gonna link it to the link here. So it's like, why REST is scalable? Exactly, right? It's exactly because of this. SOAP is not scalable because of this rigid schema. Obviously, this has been solved by protocol buffer in a very beautiful way. We're going to make another video about protocol buffers. It's still using a schema, but it's a very smart way. So you can still change, but all the client won't break. All right, guys, that's all for me. That's why I have people be moving from SOAP to newer technologies like REST and Google protocol buffers. It's because of all these reasons, right? I'm gonna pass the question to you. Have you ever used SOAP? Do you still think it's a good technology? I'm not dissing the technology, but just pointing the bad things about it and the choices, right? It could be enhanced, but what do you think, right? Did you ever use SOAP? Are you still using it? Have you moved to another protocol, and why? And I'm gonna see you in the next one. If you're new to this channel, that's what we do in this channel. We discuss software engineering concepts, and if you really check out the other content in my channel, and I'm gonna see you in the next one. You guys stay awesome. Bye bye.